going to quickly hit on the cameras, which there's a dual camera setup, like I mentioned, on the iPhone 12. So you're getting a wide and ultra wide sensor, which is great. The iPhone SE 3 is, you know, a single wide angle lens, which I think is okay too. I will tell you 4K 60 on the back of both of them. The iPhone SE 3 can only do 1080p on the front, where the iPhone 12 can do 4K 60 on the front. So that's a really big thing to keep in mind. With something like the iPhone SE 3, like I mentioned, I think this was a great camera maybe like 5 years ago, but nowadays it is kind of dated. You know, you do have video mode, obviously you have time-lapse, slow-mo, you have portrait mode as well, which is nice, but you don't have a crazy amount of features like we used to before. I think things like, you know, taking photos outside and possibly even like social media applications like Snapchat and TikTok, those are going to be fine for the most part. You're really not going to feel like this is a super outdated camera in that standpoint, but it is coming to a point where 4K 60 on the front would be nice. Having an ultra-wide sensor telephoto lens would be nice too, and we don't have that on this iPhone. Now with something like the iPhone 12 on the other hand, we do have that ultra-wide sensor, which is really, really nice. Having that capability of just utilizing an extra lens like that is really cool. Even though it lacks that telephoto lens, it's still really nice to have this extra lens just hanging out there. You still have, you know, the ability of zooming in a lot. You still have portrait mode. The same modes are pretty much on both, so it's not like one iPhone is going to have better modes than the other one, but it is nice to have that additional ultra-wide sensor. So I say that to say the iPhone SE 3's camera is still pretty good, but I do like having that iPhone 12 camera. I think it is a little bit better when it comes down to it. And to be honest, that kind of takes us to the